Yeah, I'm good to go.
Okay.
If that
All
was
right.
the
Thank
actual
you.
question.
That was an actual question.
Okay. That's my answer.
All right. Last time you finished at the snail racing, you headed over to do some other things around the park, and you had a meeting with Witch and Light, in which you managed to steal the pocket watch of Witch, hoping to give you some leverage to find out what is going on in this carnival, seeing as they didn't really want to answer your questions without it. You were told by Burly to head back to the crowning of the Witchlight Monarch, and if you had impressed the carnival enough that you would be crowned and you would all be invited to speak with them again in private, which would be the perfect place to establish your leverage and maybe get the answers that you seek. But in the meantime, you've got a couple of hours until then. You have just ridden the bubble pot teapot and landed your bubbles near the gondola swans. I believe that is where you were heading to, but you may head wherever you like. Where
To
would
the
you like to
swan,
head? To the swans?
swan,
to the swan,
swandler,
swandalers.
swandler. I noticed you
Swandalers.
didn't write it on the map, Beth.
I'm not writing that on the map.
What a disappointment.
You write on the map.
I fine. I will.
Oh,
I will, and I'm going to do it freehand, not even
God,
in
no.
text.
Stop this.
I'm going to do it in the most obnoxious color. Let's
Oh, my
find it.
God.
Do the Supermanus.
Okay, let's do it like this. Oh my god, what is
Ooh.
what are these colors that you're picking?
Bold.
Oh my
I'm gonna have
god.
to.
I have to move the camera so everyone can see what you're writing. There you go.
Stunning.
Swandler. Beautiful.
There you go. I don't know why it's done it like that, but here we are. Now you have fluorescent pink and
At
green
least you know where you're
combo.
going.
Couldn't miss it.
Oh my god.
It's just a big neon sign above
Yeah, it's just like flickering in the distance.
Yeah, Gondolas one's crossed out.
Yep. Well, you head over to the swan area. You can see
Gondolas.
enormous. Sorry, the swandlers. You see enormous swans gliding through the water, pulling ornate wooden gondolas draped in flowers. The swans disappear into banks of silver mist as they bend their way down the river. A jetty extends ahead, at the end of which there is a waiting swan preening its feathers.
I'm gonna get in.
Is it how many is in it? Like, how many people can fit in it? That makes sense.
Four.
Oh, okay.
Perfect.
Mistral will also.
There's like two seats in the front, two seats in the back.
I'm right at the front, very excited.
As you
I
approach the,
I'll sit at the back and put my feet up and annoy whoever's in the front. I'm in the back as well. Kicking this draw in the
You see the swan kind of finishes preening and looks back at you all. And then begins to speak.
No,
it's quite unsettling.
I don't like this.
Travel, is it?
Yes,
I love unicorns.
The swan bows her head. She looks to the dock to see if any more of you, and then begins to pull away from the end of the jetty.
Like how she checked when she was full.
Hey, you might have small children.
Well, it
But they
looks
can
like
go in a
such
separate
responsible parents.
one.
This swan is huge. Compared to, if you've seen swans before, they can be quite intimidating at the small size that they are. This one is giant.
She got
She's
those
very
teeth and
large.
everything.
I'm sure if she opened her mouth, she would be quite scary. But she pulls forward with the gondola, pulling you slowly down the river. Not going at a very fast pace by any means, but a nice slow journey as she begins to take you on the rivers around the carnival itself. once you pull sort of into the main river, she kind of stops focusing on where she's going, seemingly made this journey many times, as she turns to you. How do I know that you exist?
Good question.
We know you exist. We could all be a figment of each other's imagination.
Hmm. Very wise. She seems happy with your response and turns back, continues.
Hey, folks.
Can I pluck a feather out?
It's just plastic.
Okay, that's what I'm wondering. You can definitely try. Are you trying to do it stealthily or are you just being
No, I just open? Gonna pluck a feather.
Okay. Make a sleight of hand check to try and reach forward and not fall out of the gondola.
Can I help?
If you want, if you see, how are you going
to
aid?
I want to make sure that Orla doesn't fall out, basically.
Okay.
I mean, I think I'm good, but...
Okay, roll your aid if you want to aid. You can roll to aid if you want.
That's Pathfinder.
Well, you can roll to give... Oh, you're just giving her advantage then.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you may as well roll again and see if you get that 20.
Just
the best. Oh my god. Okay, you managed to lean forward, and without too much pressure, you see a feather that seems to be already on its way out. And you pull it, and it comes free in your hand. It is very large. And you now have a feather of a giant swan in your hand.
Great.
I'm gonna put
like,
my
now
head.
What do I do?
Put it in my hair or something? On there.
I'm gonna put my head in my hands and mutter.
You continue on the river for probably about 20 minutes before the swan turns back around, seemingly making small talk with you all. She says, "What is joy?"
Oh, God. Mistress is just gonna, like, look away from this weird swan that keeps talking to him. Not engage. Pretend, like, they don't hear this.
I rock the boat.
Well, if no one else is answering, I'm going to answer and say, joy is a feeling of happiness when you see those you love.
Ah, thank you.
Like, stare at Cassandra like, whoa. That was
weird. Damn. She turns back and continues pulling the boat. Seemingly happy with your response. If you would like to rock the boat, I do have a DC for that.
I so want to rock the boat.
Okay, if you want to rock the boat, I'd like everyone to please make a dexterity saving throw.
Oh my gosh, yes.
Oh yeah, I'm so good at this. I'm like, have you seen the video of the person who stands on like the mechanical bull and just like...
Oh, the master of a
That's
balance.
Like what this
is doing this boat. Why am I imagining Mister with like arms crossed like I am not part of this?
It's 'cause it's exactly
but still
what's
managing
happening.
To stay well within the boat.
Yeah.
Solana and Cassie? Dex saves, yeah. Please. Oh, you did yours.
Yeah.
Cassie?
I'm sorry.
He's going over.
Sorry, it's been slow.
It's thinking about
it. 1 minute. It's thinking, yeah. I'm thinking some more.
Important.
So doesn't know whether to be nice or horrible.
Doing a big think.
Yeah.
It doesn't like it today, does it? It's not having it.
Oh, it's because it finally came through. DND Beyond.
Yeah, it's because it's set it up to roll the dice physically and it just slows it down.
Oh, you can turn that off if you need to.
How?
If you go into your settings on D&D Beyond, I think it's in there.
Oh, thank you.
What did you roll on D&D Beyond? Just so 9. I know.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, there you go. It came through now. Okay. Alright, you rock the boat, and everyone is kind of taken by surprise for a second, but you all managed to grip the side of the boat pretty well. Apart from Cassie, who for a split second almost go over the side of the boat. You just made the DC as you grip onto that side of the boat with your dear life. As the rocking comes to a stop.
And that, Cassie, is joy.
Does Cassie respond?
Yes, she is. All of a sudden, you hear me mutter, and then a strange smell that stinks appears for
me. Are you stink bombing your own boat?
No, you also can't get away from it.
Yeah, it's the back of the boat that I'm at the front.
Oh my god. She will start to smell this horrible stink. Even the swan turns around like
how well I like it.
Hey, guess what? I hold my breath because I don't need to breathe. I'm just not gonna breathe in.
Actually, I think that is joy. And smack.
Can I roll to see how well I like disguise how awful the smell
is? Yeah, of course you can.
That would be like
a performance, I would say.
You actually smell like sniffing it. The start of a very weird turn for this campaign.
Yeah, I mean, we're already there.
Oh my god!
It's... wow.
Does that mean you hate it or you love it?
What are you trying to perceive? Are you trying to show that you are not bothered at all?
Yeah.
Oh, well, there you go. It strikes you that maybe the smell didn't even reach all that unfazed.
I'm just sitting there smoking.
Is Solana the only one who's like,
Yeah. It's fine, I'll cast it again, but stronger. This is unlimited.
I like the fact it says the faint odor, and you're like, it stinks.
If you put it over and over again, it's gonna be.
Yeah, I just gag.
My god! The swan starts to look around at you all. She seems a bit interested in what's going on in the boat.
She crashes because she's not looking where she's going.
She seems to actually, while she turns around to look at you, she is still moving forward, and she doesn't seem to have to look where she's going. She's lived on this trip quite a lot. She says, "Is this joy you are engaging in?"
Yes.
Not for me.
Smells like joy.
Does it spark joy, though? Is it gonna light on fire if...
Oh, no.
Light a match?
In a... because I can't breathe.
In a world full of such magic, is time an illusion?
This is the weirdest boat trip I've ever been.
I want you to know I'm writing a note throw this. It's just weird swan asks weird questions. The boat trip.
Oh, the boat trip.
Also, Cassie farted and pretended it was Druidcraft.
Yeah, I'm going to turn back and say.
Is time an illusion? Was that the question?
Yep.
I think it's a construct, but it's real if you believe it.
Ah. Do you believe it?
Depends on who I'm with.
Tell me, are you enjoying your time at the carnival?
I suppose so.
And would you consider it time well spent?
Yeah. I don't know what else I'd be doing with this time.
What about you, Swan? You enjoying your time? Do you feel joy?
I don't know what joy is. But I enjoy helping others. You get a good view of the carnival from my path.
I think joy would be tipping out the back of the swan.
Yeah, to the top.
I get to see many things.
What have you seen, Swan?
A few interesting things. A proposal gone wrong. A bugbear lost in his mind. Wasted guarding the staff wagons. Missing his brother horrendously. But no one knows what happened to him. And no one seems to remember.
Missing brother and mind, I'm gonna write. Wait, what happened to Burley?
I think that is Burley.
I do not know the creature's names, I just observe.
Why did the bugbear lose his mind?
I don't know.
Anything else?
Doesn't strike me as smart as he should be.
Oh.
Then maybe that's how he is. Who am I to judge?
A swandler.
What is a swandler?
You is a swandler.
You is.
I am a swan, and you ride in the gondola.
You're a swandalier.
Yeah, together you're a swandler.
That seems like a more fitting title.
I hate this game. I quit.
Though if you wish to call me by a name, you may call me Featherine.
Featherine.
That's a very swan name.
It was passed
That's
down through my generations.
Name. That was Mistral wouldn't have said that. I'm sorry. That was Ollie bleeding through. sorry. Have you ever seen, how to describe them if you don't go by names? A very strange pair. The ones who run the carnival.
Oh yes.
Ever doing something out of the norm?
What is the norm?
Out of their usual routine?
There is no routine here. The only thing that happens on time is the extravaganza and the crowning. Everything else is but a roll of the die.
The swan knows too much.
Cock's gun.
Sure. I hope we can get a bit of information from this feathering.
What ride should we go on next?
I've not ridden anything myself, so I'm afraid I cannot advise.
Do you want to? Do you want to join us on the next one?
No.
I'd ask.
Are we like taking a circuit of the whole carnival?
Yeah.
On this ride, okay.
Yeah, so if you look on the map, the river like goes all the way around.
Yeah, I just noticed.
You're on this gondola for about an hour as she takes you around the whole of the park.
So do we go through the area where the dragonfly rides are then?
No. It goes round past the carousel.
Oh, is it good down? Okay.
And then down that way.
Oh, I see. Oh, but there's a swan up there.
Yeah, this one doesn't seem to go that way.
Exclusive route.
No question.
That's just a rogue actual swan.
Yeah, it is. She doesn't work here.
Same for this one as well. Yeah.
They've not got wings. Wait, do they have butterfly wings?
The swans don't seem to have butterfly wings on. She does have a nice necklace.
Why don't you have butterfly wings?
Can I take it?
Okay.
Not enough time to have it.
Do not need them. I am not at risk of the ones who attack those who don't wear them. So we don't have to wear them.
That's what do you know about them? And why don't they attack you?
I don't think they like the water. They don't tend to attack the hands here, is what they call them. However, to make everyone feel like they are part of the same thing, I believe they have everyone wear them for safety, from what I can gather. However, I do see the thieves sometimes. They're not for long.
Whereabouts do you see them?
Yeah.
Sorry.
All over. They seem to find ones who are without the wings and take them to a different place. I see them around the Illusion Hall sometimes.
Like, did we hear that before? We were gonna meet that oh god. what were they called? Did they have a name? The Kenku? Did we not ask them their name? Cool.
Probably not.
Good on us.
Nice.
We're gonna meet them back at the Hall of Illusions at some point.
Yeah, they told you that they'd wait for you there, but there was no real rush.
Oh, yeah. I have not written a name. I wrote the name of the fae that they were looking for, or something.
Apparently we need to go to sensitivity training as well. Whoops. The first people by memory.
You wrote down the goblin.
I wrote down my snail.
not the Kenku that you interrogated in an alleyway.
Quippers? I just have Quippers really randomly.
Quippers?
Quippers, no, that's not her name.
That is.
Well, she should have told us her name.
I think she did.
That was not, that would only been polite.
I think she told you her name.
We were a bit busy interrogating her.
Sorry, I was just trying to figure out if I could. Nope, I definitely haven't written it. Whoops.
Have you heard of the forms of the three thieves?
Oh god. Yes, maybe. Oh shit.
Is one a little girl?
Yes.
Oh, girl with pig mask. Yes. And then another. But the person who told us hadn't seen or knew.
A toad?
I've seen this one. I've seen all three.
What form do they take?
The one that looks like a toad is more humanoid than toad. Though I suppose that would be the closest to describe them.
Oh, I thought they were Oh no, the girl's wearing a mask. The others are just... Okay.
The third is harder to find. I only catch glimpses in the shadows. They seem to be made of shadow themselves. Though, the form wears a mask as well. It looks almost crescent moon in design. With a dress and long hair, I would assume it was a female, but I don't know. I would not like to judge.
That's very presumptuous of you, feathery.
I said I would not like to judge.
Ah, but you just did. Someone else needs sensitivity training, I feel.
It's all of you and then the swan sat at the table.
We're all sat in the swan.
Yeah, this is where it takes us. Just takes us off.
Yeah, what does like the inside of this one look like? Does it look like benches like in a gondola, or is it like...
Yeah, you're not sat in the swan. The swan is like pulling the gondola.
Oh, I'm imagining like those pedal boats.
No, no. You're like, you're in a boat that the swan is pulling.
And she's literally a giant swan.
She's
okay,
just a giant swan, yeah.
That makes way more.
No, we're in the swan, bit of butts and
You're not sat in her.
I also didn't even question the fact that we could rock the boat and she wouldn't have even
cared.
She didn't care. Whoops.
Little insight for you. If you would have pissed her off, she would have rocked you out of the boat.
She could certainly try.
Oh, yes, she could.
I have a cast iron grip.
You seem to be approaching back where you started, if you have any more questions for Featherine.
So the toad, does the toad humanoid person wear a mask? Or are they just...
Not that I've seen.
Okay.
They have large eyes. So I'm unsure if that is a mask or just their face.
She definitely needs to go to sensitivity training. I don't know if they just look weird or if it's just their face.
You'd understand if you'd seen them.
Wouldn't judge them.
We haven't seen anyone skulking around like that, I'm presuming.
Nope.
Cool, okay. No, I haven't.
Well, you wouldn't have seen them yet.
I think I need to switch my career to a sensitivity coach.
Do they only appear?
It'd be really good.
They usually only appear between the big top and the crowning, when the stars are the highest in the sky.
Oh, so before it's crowned. Oh, so between now and then? Because we've already done the big top, extravaganza. Oh, okay.
I think the one with shadows would struggle to travel the way they do without the night.
So, I'll turn to... I say turn. Everyone else is in front of me.
I turn around to the back of the gondola.
I face away from everyone. So, should we investigate that Hall of Illusions then? If they're meant to appear near there.
That's a good plan.
Yeah.
Best place to start.
Should we do it after a few more rides so it looks like we're having fun?
So it looks like.
Put our hands up and be like, "Wee!"
Well, according to our little handy guide map here, all we need to do is do four things to become the happiest. So we've already done four. These faces are really creepy, by the way, in the bottom right.
In the bottom right, yeah.
I hate these.
But I wanted to do the dragon ride and the mystery mine. And then we could do the whole, and that kind of works our way around to the Hall of Illusions.
Because what time is it now? Like, I know are these hour increments?
Yeah, they're in hour increments. I'd say you're probably about halfway between Big Top and the Crownin'. Because
yeah, so
this ride took like a whole hour.
Oh.
We don't have a massive amount of time left, though.
But the dragonflies and
you've only got a couple things left to do.
We can just quickly do that, you know?
Yep.
You run off, it's like at the end when the theme park's about to close and you run up and you're like, oh my god,
get in line, get in line!
Yep. You can do that and then go hang around with the Hall of Illusions.
Okay.
It's just an idea, obviously.
See, she pulls into the dock that you originally got on from and slows down.
And so I'm going to jump out and say thank you and start running, looking at
She like bows her head at you. As you see Cassie just bolting it.
Follow, I suppose. A bit confused. Like, yeah,
no time to waste.
Between.
Cassie's gone.
Whoa. Yeah. Cassie. Okay, we can do this, and this. If we run and get there, we'll take 2 minutes to run over here, and then we can go on this.
Yeah, Cassie's like the dad at the airport. She's like, we have to do that this time, or everything is ruined.
And then you're there,
you've got, like, too much time.
Wait, if I shout Cassandra, does she have to stop to dance, or does she run and dance?
You'll just have to see.
So I totally shout Cassandra.
Make a perception check, Cassie, because you are running away from them. Oh, that's performance.
Yeah, I've done a road performance. I've got good hearing. I'm a high elf.
You do hear the faint echoing of your name as you run away.
Yeah. I twirl and run away twirling and dancing.
Spinning.
Yeah, literally doing twirls throughout the crowd. I look like my own show.
Oh my god. You see some other people turn around and start like, woo, yeah! And, like, children are like watching and pointing as she walks past.
Definitely underestimated her.
Well, I will run as well.
I'm pretty sure Mistral doesn't go anywhere bad.
Yeah, so Mistral, I imagine Mistral starts to follow in like the complete wrong direction.
Like,
and then Solana's like, nope.
Keep an eye on them. Make sure they are not.
The other way, Start to run the wrong way. I'm like running towards the south instead of over. Was it the dragon ride? You were going to the dragonfly ride?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I start running towards the carousel instead.
No. Roll to see who gets there first.
I mean, Cassie got a pretty good head start.
Yeah, but I
will be here.
I have a cunning action, which is. Can I do a triple move?
Oh god. I mean, if you all want to race...
I don't know how that works.
Then, I mean, you can race if you want.
No, it's fine.
Okay, if you're not racing, you get to the dragonfly rides. You can see there are huge lily pads resting on the surface of a pool, glistening with algae. Giant dragonflies use the lily pads as landing platforms, buzzing loudly overhead with wings as brilliant as stained glass windows, alighting briefly to drop off and pick up excited passengers. Near the entrance, a small smiling tree turns your way and beckons you over, with a red squirrel clung to its leafy canopy peering at you suspiciously.
Go wherever.
You recognise this tree
here at the squirrel.
As the one who gave you your gifts when you first entered.
How did it get over here?
You see it is stood up with two legs made of branches and roots. As you look into his hair and it seems to be covered in like ribbons and banners and all sorts of decoration. And the tree also seems to be wearing butterfly wings. As he looks over at you and starts to wave, almost looking like he's waving in slow motion as you all approach.
Back up.
I was just saying, go wide around the tree.
As you seem to back up from him, he kind of rears back with like a sad expression with his hands up to his face as he looks a bit worried. And he looks to his little red squirrel friend. And the squirrel kind of sniffs in your direction.
Glare. Side glare. And wave at the
don't
tree.
Like dragonflies. So I'm gonna skip this one.
I'll
watch everyone's bags.
Don't stay completely in this very spot then. Do not move.
Is that an order?
No, you know what? I'll just stay. I'll stay out.
It's not worth the risk.
Yeah. I just get distracted and I'm like, ooh. Away.
I want to get my dragonfly.
I guess.
See, the tree is kind of like waiting awkwardly as he's like fumbling with his fingers. He's very tall.
I'm going to walk up to him.
He looks down at you and he's like towering over you. You can see he's like holding his hands in front of him as he looks down at you and he says, I didn't scare you, did I?
No.
Oh. I thought I did because you all ran away from me.
I didn't.
They did.
Who cares? Yeah, they don't like dragonflies, apparently.
Oh. Well, I'm not a dragonfly.
On the ride, you could go over and ask them.
I don't think I should.
I think you should.
I don't know. Red said to just ignore them. And he motions to the squirrel on his shoulder.
Or you could do that, or if they were scared of you, you could prove that you're not scary by talking to them.
I don't think they want to talk to me. It's okay. I'm happy to speak with you instead.
It's lovely. It's nice to talk to you. Now can I go on a dragonfly?
Of course. And he sort of turns around and it's almost like his movements are in slow motion with the size of him. As he starts to slowly walk into the area of the lake.
You just see an eye roll and her muttering under her breath as he walks slowly.
He's large, he's got long strides, okay? He heads up to one of the lily pads and pulls on the reins of the dragonfly as he brings it to the closest lily pad to you. Holds it. Is it just you that is riding?
I'll get on as well.
Oh, you made me jump.
Hey.
Hi. I like your ears.
Thanks. I like your leaves.
He like covers his face. Who is driving?
I'll drive.
Oh no.
He hands you the reins. And he gives you a brief instruction on how to steer the dragonfly. The dragonfly will know where it's going, but if you get up high, sometimes they get distracted. So you will have to steer them back.
We're riding a mistral dragonfly.
And he begins to like lean down and just picks you up and places you both on the dragonfly with his long tree arms. Have a good flight. As he like passes you the reins, Orla, and steps away. The dragonfly's wings start to flutter as it begins to set off into the air with you both. So the dragonfly flies essentially like a lazy figure eight across the whole of the carnival, about 20 feet up, so not super high, probably a bit lower than you went in the bubble, but this is a more casual ride as it's generally just to give you a view over the carnival.
Can I see if I can see anything suspicious on the ground?
Yes, so you can make a perception check while you're up there, while you get a good view.
Yeah, can I look out for the thieves as well?
Yeah, both of you make a perception check while you're up there. Okay. Orla, there's so many people down there that you can't really specify anyone. You're looking for the weird-looking individuals, but there are a lot of weird-looking individuals in this place.
Hey, look, there's Mistral.
Yeah, Mistral and Solani, you see them looking down at you as they fly
lying
overhead.
In the grass.
The dragonfly. Cassie, you see what looks to be a girl in a pig mask. Like, what? The description. She seems to be heading down past the big top towards the Hall of Illusions with sort of hand in hand with what looks like a young girl.
I'm going to point and go there.
Can I steer the dragonfly that way? Or is it like not allowed out of a certain area?
The dragonfly seems to be on its set path, but if you want to roll an animal handling check, you can see if you can steer it out of its path.
Yeah, I'll give it a go. Oh,
no.
You try and pull on the reins, but it's like it's set on its path and it doesn't want to move as it just continues flying you overhead around in this figure eight and starts heading back towards the start where you first got on. As you seem to be getting further away from where you saw them.
Then I'll cast a message.
Okay.
And I'll send a message to Solana and I'll say, the little girl in the pig mask it's heading towards Wall of Illusions.
Okay. I don't know if I can reply to you, but if I can, I will acknowledge the message, and I'll...
I acknowledge this message.
I'll tell Mistral. Gonna tap on Mistral, tell him, I'll say, pig mask and a little girl to go in towards the Hall of Illusions. Shall we go?
Yeah, I think.
Well, let's go and follow it, Melchie.
As you look up, you can see that Dragonfly seems to be coming in to land. It's up to you if you want to wait for them or if you want to head off.
Should we meet them there? They'll know how to get there.
They might get there before us, but we should try.
Yeah, let's go, let's go.
Let's go.
Alright, you start heading off.
I should not lead the way.
I will lead the way. Hold of Mistral's arm so they don't get lost behind me and they don't try and go a different way.
Okay. Make a perception check, both of you, as you are heading towards that area to see if you can see these individuals.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Oh, it's a good thing that you rolled really well.
Okay, Mr. You're pretty much just being dragged about by Solana. It's hard to take anything in. Solana is like a woman on a mission. She is dragging you in the right direction, and you can see now in the distance, sort of not yet reached the Hall of Illusions, but kind of trying to... You can see this individual with the child, and they both seem to be the same sort of height. You know, it's not like an adult trying to take a child away, it seems like two children. But one of them is wearing the pig mask. However, the child that they're holding hands with has sort of stopped to look at a stall, which has given you enough time to sort of catch up with them. Meanwhile, the other two, you have now come to land at the Dragonfly Rides. If you want to start making your way over, it's up to you.
Making your way.
Yeah, we're gonna dash, bolt again.
You'll run over. Okay. So Solana and Mistral, you managed to approach. What would you like to do as you see this child and what looks like a child, both stood at this stall, not seemingly looking at you currently?
Nice mask.
You see the child with the mask turns around and they look at you. This mask looks like it's been taken off a real pig.
Oh my
it's
God.
Not a nice looking, you know, like cartoony mask. It is horrible. The skin of this child is like blues and greys in hue. They don't seem to be wearing any shoes. However, they are carrying what looks to be a large lollipop as they turn to you and kind of tilt their head and then pull on the hand of the child as if to try and get them to come away.
Wait, where did you get that lollipop? I want one too.
They seem...
just like trying to walk in front.
Irritated as they're trying to pull this child away, but you can see the child is very engaged in this activity at the stall. And they start saying, just wait a minute, I just want to get this teddy and then I'll come with you.
Have we gotten there yet?
You two would just be about approaching at this point. You can see Mistral and Solana kind of blocking off the path of this child.
You know, really want to enjoy the carnival and would just really like a lollipop like that. Where did you get it? What stall did you get it from?
You hear this like guttural growl towards you.
Cool.
as the child kind of like swats away at you to leave them alone.
Why are they doing that? Can I grab the other child?
Yeah, I mean, so the child is currently distracted, so you can definitely try, but they do have their hand held by this other creepy looking child. So,
am I sufficiently distracting creepy looking child?
you're definitely engaging them.
By being annoying.
So I'd say this would be like a contested, like, I'd say you can do, I'd say advantage athletics against their athletics or acrobatics, as this is kind of like a contested grapple.
Okay.
For this kid, but I'll give you advantage because they are distracted and the child isn't paying attention.
Cool. I'm trying to grab the actual child.
Not the scary one. Oh no! Hey, it's a good thing you got advantage. Yeah.
Please.
Yeah.
Please, second roll.
Okay, let's see what they rolled.
Ow.
Okay. You managed to snatch the child away from the booth with such force that it pulls their hand away.
Hand clean off!
Yeah, they fall straight off onto the floor. No. And the child, kind of startled, looks up at you like, oh, who are you? And the child in the pig mask looks very uncomfortable with this situation, as I would like you all to please roll initiative.
Security.
For the first time in this campaign. Oh my god.
Oh boy. Love that for me.
Oh boy. Alright, let's move you to the map that I needed. See? I told you I might need the map.
Uh-oh.
You have a picture of the kid with the pig mask?
I do. I'll send it you now.
I want to see this.
Alright, so you should be able to see that now. You can place yourselves where you want, so this is the stall that they are at. You've just snatched the child, so they're there, and the creepy looking child is here next to them. So place yourselves where you would like.
I suppose I was like in front, so I'd
be... Yeah, you were trying to like block them off. Let me get you a picture of this.
I was right by Mistral, so...
Am I...
Yeah, I would have been next to
the
Cassie.
I feel, am I bigger than the square? Is that why this is happening?
Yeah, don't worry about the squares on the map. Just let me crop this so you don't get spoilers. All right, let me post it in the room. NPCs.
Are we gonna beat up a kid in the middle of the carnival?
That's what they look like.
It's fine, it's all for show.
Okay. So. Marcel just came in and all the dogs have run in and I was trying to get them out silently. It's fine, just leave the door open. It's fine, okay. Okay, so initiative tracker. Are you all happy with where you put yourselves before I start this?
Yeah.
Alright, yeah. Let's add you all in. I guess the child would have a turn. Okay, Solana, what did you get?
19.
Cassie?
20.
20. Mistral?
A six?
Oh no, I'm pressing all the buttons. I've made myself look angry and sad at the same time. Oh no. There we go, fixed it. Orla?
15.
15, okay.
Oh, how the tables turn.
Let's roll for my creepy child. Okay. Alright. Oh no, I've done it again. Stop using the numpad. Might as well roll for the child, okay. All right, let's start off with we'll start off with a surprise round as the child lashes out at you with the fingers.
The fingies.
Which child?
The
creepy child or creepy child.
The creepy, alright, we'll say creepy child. Creepy child is going to try and scratch at you, Cassie, as you pull the child away from them to start off the combat. Yeah. So they will step up towards you to try and hit you. And this is what initiated the combat.
Can I hit that,
then? Well, this is the start of the combat. So
Is
what's like sent it off.
I see.
As they sort of like lash out at Cassie. Misses you, though. As you kind of just step out of their grasp and they look very angrily in your direction. We're now at the top of the initiative, if you would like to go, Cassie.
Oh, I am going. Yeah. With one hand, the child, and with the other.
This doesn't feel very,
I get the combat music on, hold on.
Like an evil child is attacking us.
Hold on. Stop this. Play this.
Stop this.
There we go. This is better. All right. So you poison spray? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Is it a con save?
Yeah.
Futuristic.
All right. As you feel the spray leave your... How do you spray? Are you blowing it from your hand into the creature? Are you spitting it? Like, how do you visualize that?
I feel like it's just me throwing my hand and it kind of coming out of my hand and it's spacing.
Like Spider-Man.
Oh.
Yeah.
You see it hit the creature. However, it's like you just splashed water on them. Where usually there would be like a sizzle and some damage behind it, they don't seem affected at all. Would you like to do anything else?
Yeah, bonus catnip, I'm gonna cast the Judgecraft and make some fancy flashing lights.
Okay, just so you know, Druidcraft generally can't be used in like combat settings.
Oh, I'm not using it for combat. I'm
You're
making
just
it like
making
look
it
showy.
Look nice.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Live your life.
I'm trying to make it look like a show so people don't think we're attacking a child.
Okay. Alright. Would you like to move? You also have the child in hand.
Yeah. I'll move, dragging the child.
Okay. If you step away, they are going to try and attack at you. They're going to try and swipe at you again.
I know, but the kind of the child I've got by the scruff of the neck is probably a bit.
They rolled a 12.
That does not hit.
It does not hit. As they again just miss their mark as you step out of their range. How far can you move? I'd say pulling the child you can move half speed because you're moving with them, like you've grappled them for essentially. The child currently doesn't know what's going on, so it's not like they're moving with you willingly.
Yeah, move 15
30. Okay, I'll move the child with you to there.
And then can I kind of shift the child behind me? Yep. Actually, no, right by the scruff of the neck, it's not going anywhere. But behind me, and turn to face.
I think you're confusing children for cats. Generally, you can't grab children by the scruff of the neck.
I'm imagining by their clothes, you know, when you drag them.
I just imagine you like grabbing them by the skin.
Yeah, no, just by the scruff of their top.
Oh my god, okay. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, if that's your turn, Solana, it's your turn.
Can I move here?
Yep.
And then... So, creepy child. I'm gonna just say that I love unicorns. as part of this, I will cast Charm Person. I hope that has charmed them sufficiently at the creepy child. I'll try.
Okay.
I don't know if it's actually a child. We'll see.
Alright. So that's a wisdom save. Okay.
It gets an advantage, I think, if we're kind of in a fighting situation.
Okay. Well, you cast a spell and you feel it go across to this creature where it would usually hit a person. You don't feel that connection as it fizzles away. It doesn't seem like it can be charmed.
That's no child.
rings alarm bells to you that this might not be a child.
I'm gonna pull out my sword.
You're just like, that's no child.
That's no child. Sword time!
Oh, that's my turn, I think.
Alright. Ola.
I'm like, oh my god, we're gonna fight a child?
That's not a child, I said that.
Oh, well, that's fine then.
Yeah, you can kill it.
Can I just, like, slap the lollipop out of their hand?
The lollipop gives them their
power. Oh my god, how did she know? Yeah, you can try and disarm them. Let me look up disarm rules. Disarming attack. Does it have a general disarm rule? Let's see. Okay, so you can make an athletics or acrobatics check contest with the creature to try and knock it out of its hand. So it's like a grapple, essentially. Okay.
Can I do acrobatics?
Yeah, and I'll roll for the creature.
You do a flip and kick it.
Wappa!
Here I do.
Oh wow, they rolled a 12. So you, you managed to kick the lollipop free from their hand as it goes skidding into the table opposite.
Do they react in any way?
They look furious as they, like, hiss and seem to almost bare their teeth at you. And now that you've got a closer look at the bottom half of their face under this mask, you can see their teeth are sharp but rotted as their flesh seems to be discoloured. As they bare their teeth at you, and you hear this low guttural growl again, almost feral.
I do that back, but my teeth are so much better.
Your teeth are well nicer.
Yeah. Got them whitened.
Would you like to move? Any bonus actions?
No, I'll just stay and do what I'm doing.
Alright. Listen. Okay, it's the, It's the creepy child's turn. They're not very happy that you kicked their lollipop away, so they're going to attempt to bite at you and then claw at you.
Oh, you're going to get brown teeth on you.
They rear forward to try and bite into your arm with a 13.
Yeah, that just hits.
Okay. You take... Eight points of damage.
Oh god.
As you feel these rotten teeth where you think there might be like decayed and maybe a bit flimsy, it pierces into your arm with this horrible sensation. As it pulls away, it also tries to slash at you with its hand. But it misses.
They're like, guys, it bit me!
You can see this like rotten, like brown, horrible grossness now on your hand where it had you in its mouth.
Ew!
Why would you phrase it like that? That sounds disgusting.
It is had disgusting.
You in its mouth. Had you in its mouth.
It did! Alright, that's its turn. It's now Mistral's turn.
Hi, it's me. You may be wondering how I got into this situation.
Got into this situation by threatening a child.
I threatened a child. I stood in front of a child and asked where they got their lollipop, actually. Thank you. It's not a threat.
I don't think anyone threatened the child.
Well, the child threatened you.
Well, I don't know if I can stab a child.
Stab it!
For a child!
Okay, I give in to peer pressure and I step forward, I guess, to next to it.
Okay.
Okay, well, here we go. Yes. I will attack the child.
I feel okay. Like this is actually what's happening right now. Like, this girl's like,
I'll do it. I'll stop the child. I will.
I'm like trying to warn them. I'm like, do you know what? You should stop fighting. If you know what's good for you. And I will slap my hands together, and as they bring them back out, two like very translucent, very thin daggers appear in my hand. Very, very, very thin, almost like hands. And I will attempt to attack the child.
Yes.
Having
dagger reveal.
Know how to attack? Let's have a look. okay. Eleven.
Okay, you just, I think you're fumbling a bit as you go to attack. You don't really want to attack this child. You're not fully convinced as you miss it. Only slightly.
Re-establish myself and attempt a bonus action to hit it with my other blade.
Go for it.
Oh, fuck it. I am a...
Oh! It's almost as if you faked out the child in the first hit. As you come back with this stab, like, straight into the neck. Roll your damage.
This one doesn't do as much damage, but I just click on that, I guess. Oh, I did it already. Cool.
Holy heck.
Oh, fucking Jesus.
So what's the total, though? Why is that rolled so many times? I'm so confused.
Because it's a crit. And I get a sneak attack, so that doubles
as
well.
Oh my god.
So I did 26 points of damage.
Oh my god.
As I give this child a lobotomy.
You stab this blade.
Jesus.
Into the neck of the child. And as you pull it out, you feel the limpness of them as they fall to the ground.
Oh. Oh no. Oh god.
You just killed a kid!
The daggers disappear as well as I do that. As I'm like, was that supposed to happen? I don't attack. I mean, play with children very often in that way.
Sleeping lions.
Sleeping pigs, if anything. Yeah. Pig mask, after all.
The child that's holding your hand, Cassie, is like clinging to you now and kind of hiding behind you to mask whatever is happening over there that is very scary.
I'm gonna start clapping and go, and that was the performance of our amateur theatre troupe.
Is there even anyone around?
I do a little bow and like trying to cover it up a little bit.
Make a performance check. I'd say with advantage because all is helping you. There are a couple people around as they're kind of looking over at what just happened.
Come on, advantage. As the room is, could I bend down and try and remove the mask?
Yep.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my god.
She's just not a very good actress.
Yeah, the people don't seem that convinced. You bend down and pull the mask off this child, and you can see underneath they have these piercing blue eyes, with the rest of the eyeball seems to be almost black, and their face almost rotted away.
I start pretending to fight Mistral, like to continue the act sort of thing.
Betrayal. Mistral's not stupid, I think.
Yeah. Most people seem to be like just avoiding you as opposed to challenging you.
Like I do not perceive it.
Yeah. Can I search the child?
The child doesn't seem to have any pockets or anything on them.
Oh. You just killed an unarmed child, Mistral.
Can I just one-hit KO this thing?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
As the child behind you is clinging to the back of your skirt, Cassandra, it's like, I want my mum!
Is your mum here?
She's over there somewhere.
Should we go find your mum and don't walk away with strangers? Bad things happen.
She said she was taking me to see something cool.
Well, she was lying. This is what happens when you go away with strangers. Bad things happen.
You're a stranger.
Blue people just had a disagreement, you see. So...
yeah. Let's go find your mum.
She starts to turn around with the crying child. You can see three workers of the carnival start to approach you with their wings and matching attire. Mm-hmm. They start heading over as one of them steps forward, seemingly looks to be a half-elf male, quite young looking. We heard there was something going on over here.
No?
This poor child fell on the ground.
Onto a knife.
Ah, there's nothing there. Psychic damage, it doesn't leave a mark.
The children had a disagreement.
On the ground.
Yes. The children had a disagreement. Now, if you excuse me, I need to find this one's mother.
This is the man talking to you, like, claps his hands as the other two beside him. One looks to be, like, a smaller dwarf, and the other one seems to be just a human, as they step forward. And he says, take this child back to where they were, please.
Does the child have the wings on? Or do they not have wings?
They don't seem to have their wings on.
So they don't have a ticket, or whatever.
As they seem to, hold the child's hand if you allow it. Do you allow them to take the child?
I'm going to look at them suspiciously. I'll come with the child.
I assure you we can handle it. It's our job. I think you've done enough.
Will the child be safe?
We're going to return them to their parents, of course.
Do you have spare wings?
We'll see to it. So you can see other hands of the carnival start to head over to this area as it seems to be being blocked off. And they start closing off the area that you're in. with this child still on the floor.
Hey guys, we're having so much fun at the carnival.
Can I cast calm emotions on, like, the guy that seems to be leader?
Yeah.
Yeah, and can I do an insight check?
Of course you can. Okay.
Roll. Does that help ills as well?
It depends where they aimed it.
Is it calling the child?
You feel the emotions were once a little bit tense and shocked in the situation seem to be calm in your direction and not threatening to you.
Were you returning the child to its mother without any harm coming to it?
I like the fact you keep calling the child it.
Yes!
I'm not sounds like wailing behind you. You get the sense that they are trustworthy and they're just doing their job.
I will hand over it. The child.
As you hand the crying girl over to the two workers and they start to head off. In the direction that the child had said.
I didn't want to presume. I've done my sensitivity training.
Did the crying child beat the charisma save? They continued crying while everyone else calmed down.
Did you cast it on the child or did you cast it on the man?
I thought it was an area.
That's what I'm saying. It depends where they cast it.
Well, they were close to each other, right?
Well, I mean, I was generally aiming for the guy that gets the kid as well, like.
Guy's social distance and really far away.
Yeah, it's like, don't talk to me.
He's like, ew, it.
Cough.
As you see, like, the guy kind of heads over to the child on the floor and, like, bends down and then starts covering the body with, like, a blanket that he seems to procure out of his pockets that seemed way too big. To a fit in his pocket.
She's just sleeping, right?
I think we know what happened here.
I think we know as well. So I think we should all agree to walk away.
I think that is the right choice.
Like, nothing ever happened.
I will have this sorted out.
Please make sure no one asks me about this. I can't guarantee that I won't talk.
That was a great performance, guys, don't you think? We'll do this again sometime.
Maybe it's best you don't talk to anyone.
People often know that I love unicorns. You.
Right.
Yeah.
Now please leave the area.
Why have you not done anything about it before now?
We weren't allowed to. Though, may I thank you on behalf of me and my staff team for dealing with this problem.
Well, if there's any other problems floating around, come and find us.
I'm sure there are two other problems here somewhere that we would be happy for you to deal with. However, thank you for your... kindness today, as he seems to be very cautious about what he's saying, as other members of the team sort of pile in and start to wrap the body up and start to make sure that no one is looking into this area.
Right, to the mine.
The mines.
I'll move you back to the big map.
I'm just gonna pat Mistral on the shoulder, like, that definitely wasn't a child.
But it looked like a child.
It was not a child. My spell might have worked on a child.
My spell didn't either.
I can't believe you killed a not child.
Why did my mind go through?
Because it wasn't a child. My It wasn't even a human, I don't think.
They did look really strange under the mask. Oh, damn, now I need to sign up for sensitivity training. I can't just kill strange children-looking things.
God.
The car just willy-nilly goes stabbing small, weird-looking creatures.
Well, I'll let you know in the future if it seems like a child or human. And then we'll see if what you want to do after that.
Okay.
Guys, can anyone clean this up? And I just, like, point to my gross bitten hands. That's, like, been in a child.
You can
don't
see,
say
like,
it like that. Phrasing.
The teeth marks are, like, still in your arm. They look horrible. As, like, the residue
like a couple
has been
of teeth
left.
In there.
Yeah. It is nasty.
I don't have that capability.
I do. How unwell are you feeling after that bite?
on a number scale.
No, like on a very... scale of like 1 to 17. Probably like a 9.
I see.
Let's see how you do, because I could also help out if the worst comes to worst.
Let's, I feel like my life should be valued a bit better than this. I see how it is, guys. It's fine. I just need to.
I'm running out of energy, shall we say.
You can always take
just
a short rest.
Lick my hand clean.
A short rest wouldn't help me.
You can not
take
a short rest.
Oh, for healing. No, I thought of. That's okay, I get it. <That's stupid. laughs>
But short rest is like an hour and we don't have that much time.
Oh no, we have to, why don't you, well, that's just the mine and you can have a rest on the mine.
We should have done the swans after this.
Oh, that would have been a good rest.
Yeah, you would have had a short rest, but you didn't really do anything before then.
I was just looking at my things and I don't think anything really comes back on a short rest. Maybe? I don't know. I don't know my things well enough yet to realise that.
I got like one thing that comes back on a short rest, but I haven't used it, so.
Yeah, the one thing I actually would get back on a short rest, I haven't used.
Okay. You follow the sound of screams that you heard earlier from the mine. Somewhat pleasure. Some absolute terror as you head over to this area. You see, propelled by magic, minecarts laden with fairgoers trundle into an opening carved like a dragon's mouth. The carts reappear moments later on the far side of the attraction, with the passengers expressing a mixture of bewilderment, fear, and excitement. Near the entrance, a male dwarf dressed like a wizard shouts, "Unlock the mysteries of your mind in the mystery mine!" He has bushy eyebrows, wears a pointy hat, and holds a large clockwork contraption shaped like a giant eye.
Cool, love that. What mysteries of the mind? What is this?
This is the mystery mine!
Take
cool. A ride if you dare. Look into the eye. To experience the true mysteries. As he like holds out his clockwork eye to you.
Well, I suppose there's lots of mysteries going on. Maybe I'll have some answers.
Gaze into the eye. It'll know all.
I don't want to.
I'm gonna tell him I like unicorns and I will gaze into the eye.
Intense eye contact.
Okay. You look into the eye. It looks like a clockwork contraption. You can hear a little bit of like ticking in between. But it doesn't seem to do anything. It just seems to be like an eye. As he like pulls it away from you. Don't look too long, glass. Not good for you. Anyone else?
I'll look into it.
As he holds it up to you. Again, you look into it. Doesn't seem like anything. It's just a weird clockwork eye. So he pulls it back again.
I glance at the eye.
Like a quick, like... That's enough. As he holds it towards you, Ola.
I look into it.
Okay. Again, he holds it up to you. You don't see anything exciting. For a few moments before he, like, pulls it back down. You see, he seems to be smiling. Well, get ready for a ride. As he walks over towards the rail track, as a minecart pulls up, ready for you to enter.
Is this another one where we all fit in the same cart?
Yes.
Cool.
This one holds up to 8. So you can space yourselves out if you want. It's 2x2.
Let's have 1 8. I'm gonna spread out.
Went in the cart 2x2, hurrah.
Yeah, you can all sit in your own row if you want.
Why not?
I do need to know the order of which you are sat, please.
At the very back.
I'm sat in front of Miss Store, I don't wanna go first.
Okay. I'll sit right at the front.
Alright.
I'll sit second.
And second, okay. Alright. Okay. So you all get into the minecart as the little bar comes down, and you see the dwarf, like, waving his eye at you. He says, "Have a good trip," as he pulls the lever, and you start to clunk along this track in the minecart.
I hate that guy already.
It begins on the track, and it seems to be like a normal roller coaster type ride. It's you pass through the dragon's mouth, and as you do, you see where the track was in front of you disappears, and you now see an illusory state around you as the track warps back into place. You are no longer in the park. You're in the middle of a field. And you keep travelling along. You can see giant dragonflies flying overhead.
Mister, look out!
You get deja vu sensation of the sky in the way that it was in the dream that you all had to bring you all together. As the cart seems to continue on this track through this never-ending abyss, like, you seem to go up and down as you're traveling over hills that aren't there. You can see trees and other shrubbery and plants seem to be bending in strange ways that wouldn't normally happen. And you can see the sky changing every few seconds. It seems to be changing hue, changing colour, as you're in this strange environment. Until you see the sky turns to a dark blue. The trees, the grass, the shrubbery, everything that you can see beside the cart disappears. And it's like you are plunged into this dark scenery. Ahead of you, you see a light. And as you get closer, you can see two figures stood within this light. You see one larger figure strike down the smaller as they seem to fall and perish on the floor. And as the cart gets closer, Orla, you recognize them. the corpse laying upon the floor is that of your mother, and the one stood above her is your father, seemingly killed her in cold blood right in front of you. I would like you to please make a wisdom saving throw.
Well, that's really rude.
Okay. You are compelled to scream. This illusion terrifies you to your core as you begin to tremble and fear takes over you. You are now under the fear effect until you get off the ride.
Understandably.
I hate those.
The track continues past and it begins to brighten once more, seemingly going past a plain environment again. As you see the environment change once more into what looks like a large group of people, all of them faceless and non-distinct, but seemingly surrounding you in the cart. However, Solana, you recognize them as your peers, your friends, people that you've known along the years. And as you travel alongside them, they all begin to point their fingers at you, and you hear different shouts and screams from them all. You betrayed our trust! How could you do this to us? We trusted you! Please make a wisdom saving throw.
No.
No.
As you also begin to fear this illusion, you are taken in by it. And the reality of you letting these people down and being unable to keep their secrets true and hidden begins to get to you, as you are also under the fear effect until you get off this ride.
Okay.
The scene changes once more, as again it changes to a neutral setting before. You're in what looks to be an office. Someplace seemingly organized and well looked after. Cassie, you recognize this place. This is your workplace. However, as you pass through, things start to become out of place. As you see papers tossed about, cabinets and furniture thrown, as you see deep claw marks on the floors, on the walls, on the furniture, fire breaks out within the office space, and amongst what was once a very calm, organized place, there is now chaos and feral chaos, as you see this figure hunched over, blood dripping from them, hair wild, out of control. They look at you with piercing eyes and you recognize yourself. Please make a wisdom saving throw. You managed to see through this illusion. You've seen it happen to your other two friends. And you're not going to let it get to you. You see it for what it is. It's an illusion. It's not real. And you laugh it off. And just as you overcome it, it seems to change. Again, returning to that neutral atmosphere before changing once more to an atmosphere that you recognize, Mistral. It's your home, with two figures that you also recognize. A fire genasi stands with an air genasi, almost nondescript in their facial features or outfits, but you know who they are. As they stand laughing at you, rejecting you, telling you that you'd never have been good enough for them, and that they are much happier without you. I'd like you to please make a wisdom saving throw.
Cool. Oh boy. That makes sense.
We're all so sensitive.
As you are also taken in by this, you begin to shiver and cower as you can't stand the sight of this scene playing out in front of you, as you are also under the fear effect.
I think if anything, seeing Ola and Solana freak out would have made it worse for Mistral when it came.
Especially being at the back as they've been witnessing all of this happen in front of them.
Yeah. Whereas Cassie was like, no, I can recognize this as not being normal. I think Mistral's just taken in by the atmosphere.
I don't think Cassie only did that because she's had like 100 years to control this side. So she's just like
the minecart
breathing
continues for what seems like a good few more minutes, though the sights that you see don't seem to ring true to either any of you anymore. It just seems to be now showing you random things. It shows you spiders, it shows you dragons, it shows you many different things seemingly trying to scare you. However, three of you are too scared to even look. Cassie, you're the only one really taking this in, and now that you know what it is and you know what it's about, you're not bothered by it.
I'm kind of sat awkwardly with an arm behind Solana and Mistral, like, it's okay.
You feel them shivering as they are truly terrified as you continue through. You see, coming up in front of you again, the gate that looks like a dragon. And as you pass through it, you're back. The illusion disappears and you're back on the track as it pulls back round and in to where you got on and comes to a stop. As you can see, the dwarf once more stood there, seemingly waiting for your response as he opens the door for you to exit.
I get out and I slap him.
Not a good trip then.
Fuck you.
As you feel fear fade from you. However, the memories stay. You
I turn
able
and
to
I
move again.
I help the others get out the train.
Thank you.
And then I just pull them into a hug and give everyone a hug.
No.
Mistral just has this like 1,000-yard stare.
I'm gonna cast Dunks now towards the dwarf.
He's like, don't hate on me, I just run the ride. Whew. And that's where we will end the session for today.
All aboard the trauma train.
Look, we had trauma, we killed a not child.
It wasn't a kid, it was fine. It's fine.
We rode a swan. But not a swan. We rode the gondola that the swan was
swandler.
Born. The swandler was born.
The swandler. I believe right that is the last thing that you had to experience here. It's the last attraction.
It's the best to last.
Oh, boy, oh boy.
You picked so much fun.
You picked the real fun one for the last thing, didn't you guys? Yeah, you had to pick that one.
Did we go to the Pixie Kingdom?
Oh.
No. I don't think you did, actually.
No.
Can we pick that in? And all that.
Carousel. What's the property?
We did the carousel.
The Pixie Kingdom is like a very miniature town. There's nothing really... There's not an attraction there, it's just seemingly...
Where the pixies live.
People get shrunk down to walk around it. And then you come out again. There's no, like, attraction there.
You could just be like, oh no, you guys go on ahead. And then
just... And then... How
could you? I am the true evil character.
It's like a flower garden. It's like you walk around it to look at the nice things and then you come back out.
It wasn't one of the ones recommended to us. So.
It wasn't. But you can do it if you want. I don't want to get you hyped up for the last attraction when there's nothing there.
I don't think Mistral would want to do anything else. Just be like,
I feel like I want to do it because I need to do every attraction.
You're the only one who is sane right now.
Nothing's fun anymore.
It's so funny because I'm going to go home. The knocking in the background of you, Rosie, it makes Solana look like she's talking every time. She's like jumping up and down. Oh, well. Yeah, that was a nice end to the session. Are we all good for next week?
Currently.
I believe so.
Alright. Well, we'll see you all next week. Thank you for coming to the stream, those that did. And we'll see you next week. Bye, guys.
Bye.